The despot leader oversaw an intermediate-range ballistic missile, IRBM, launch on Tuesday, which fired over Japan. It comes as World War III fears heighten and Japan earlier issued a warning telling citizens in Hokkaido to take shelter in a sturdy building or basement. Tuesday's missile was launched from Sunan, close to the North Korean capital of Pyongyang, and flew around 1,680 miles, 2,700 kilometers, before it broke into three pieces and landed in the sea around 733 miles, 1,180 kilometers, off the east coast of Japan. Despite breaking to pieces, Kim Jong-un claimed the missile was a warning to the US and South Korea over their provocative military drills. He added that the launch of the Hwasong-12 missile was also a prelude to containing the U.S. territory of Guam, as North Korea earlier warned it would fire missiles around the island. Experts believe the latest rocket is the first missile from North Korea, which is powerful enough to potentially carry a nuclear warhead. Kim Jong-un vowed his recent missile launches were the first step of the military operation of the Korean People's Army in the Pacific and a meaningful prelude to containing Guam. He added that it is a curtain raiser of its resolute countermeasures against the Seoul Washington drills. Donald Trump reiterated that all options were still on the table for dealing with North Korea's threats, as he added the world had received Kim Jong-un's message loud and clear. Speaking after the missile launch, the U.S. president said, "Threatening and destabilizing actions only increase the North Korean regime's isolation in the region and among all nations of the world. All options are on the table." Tuesday's launch comes after the rogue state fired three missiles on Saturday towards the Sea of Japan. Three either failed in flight or exploded almost immediately. The U.S. revealed its army is ready to attack North Korea, if necessary, with additional bombers stationed in its military bases in Guam. South Korean President Moon Jae-in also ordered a show of overwhelming force in response to the launch, and four South Korean jets staged a live bombing drill on Tuesday. Mr. Moon's chief press secretary, Yoon Young-chan, confirmed the drill was ordered by the South Korean military after an urgent National Security Council meeting. He added, "We assess North Korea's provocations as extremely severe and decided to maintain a vigilant posture in preparation for the possibility of additional provocations by North Korea." North Korea's ambassador to the UN claims his country has every reason to continue ramping up war tensions, as he accused the US of driving the Korean Peninsula towards an explosion. The Secret of State earlier this month revealed plans to launch four IRBMs towards US territory Guam.